So, if you're eager to learn Python, you have probably heard the advice, the best way to learn a programming language is by working on a project. But the real question is, what kind of project should you pick? In this video, I'm going to show you the best Python project you could build. In fact, I learned Python building out the application I'm about to show you. Depending on your current skills, you can either keep it simple, like tinkering around with if-else conditions, or you could go super advanced with it and integrate a ton of features, for example, connecting it to other services like ChatGPT, your email account, or even integrating machine or deep learning into it. And now here's the craziest part. I've never heard anybody on YouTube talking about this project. That means it's pretty unique. If you go to a job interview and show this project, I'm sure your potential employer will be impressed. Okay, and definitely make sure to stick to the end of this video because I will show you how you can get started today building out this application. So without further ado, here's the idea. Build a line bot. Now you might be wondering, what the heck is line? Let me explain. You probably know about the messaging service WhatsApp, which is popular in many countries. However, depending on the country, they might use other applications. For example, in Korea, most people use an app called Kakao. And in Japan, hardly anyone uses WhatsApp. Instead, they use an app called Line. I know this because I worked as a business analyst in Japan for 3 years. My job mainly involved management consulting in a commercial context, but I also built automation tools in VBA to make my office life a bit easier. Now, we also had call center operations, where customers often ask if we had certain part numbers in stock. And we were thinking about how to make this process more efficient. So, considering everyone was using Line, I thought maybe we could use this messenger for our customer service. After some research on Google, it turned out that Line is pretty developer-friendly. Unlike WhatsApp, with Line you can customize the entire chat interaction, like creating a chatbot or custom menus. But let me actually show you one of my very first prototypes. Keep in mind, at that time I was very new to Python and only had a basic understanding of it. So this is the Line messenger. As you can see, it looks like any other messenger. The idea was that the customer could enter a product part number, and then the app would automatically check in a database how many pieces of that part number we had in stock. Additionally, I also integrated a chatbot to guide the customer on how to use the messenger. In the end, we actually didn't implement this solution, as some of our main customers were actually not allowed to have the chat app installed on their business phones. However, I had so much fun creating this bot, and I was also pretty amazed by the possibilities in Python. So that is why I decided to build my own messenger bot. I called it Smart Sven. The smarter version of me would send me messages every morning. Once again, that was in 2020, and I was just getting started with Python. The morning message included information about the COVID-19 cases in Japan, the weather forecast for the next few days, a motivational message, the current JPY conversion, a useless fact about today's date, and my current YouTube stats to give me a bit of motivation to create more videos for you guys. Next, it would also send me some workout music because during the pandemic the gym were closed, so I decided to do some home workouts in the morning. It also included a little math quiz to wake up my brain and a quiz on Japanese vocabulary. Then the bot would also send me a meme and the answers to the Japanese quiz. Additionally, it picked a random music track which I hosted on my cloud, and by pressing the button here, it would also list my Google Calendar events for the day. And just to spice things up, I also created a custom menu. The bot itself doesn't work anymore. But back then, I just had to click the buttons to get, for example, stretching, yoga or workout videos, which I also hosted on my cloud. I could also get a useless fact, the current weather forecast, or even a completely random book summary, all hosted on the cloud. The list of features actually continues. For instance, whenever I posted a YouTube link into the chat, in the background it was then converting the YouTube video to an MP3 and then storing that MP3 file on my cloud. And of course, the possibilities are endless. You could also build a menu to trigger Python scripts that send out emails, for example, fetch financial data, or perform any other automation task in Python. So it's really up to you what you want to build with it and how far you want to go. And you're actually not limited to simple text messages. Line also supports videos, images, audio, stickers, and even buttons. So whatever you can build with Python and is accessible via internet, this could be potentially integrated into your application. For example, you could post a picture in a chat and in the background trigger your deep learning model and then send the response back to the chat, just as an idea. I can say from my experience that I had so much fun building my bot and adding more and more features every day. While building it, my Python skills really improved. And after a while, I was also confident enough to build another chatbot for my colleagues in Japan. As I mentioned, the gym were closed during the pandemic, and most of us were forced to stay at home. To give my colleagues a bit of motivation to still exercise, I created a line bot called FitBuddy. FitBuddy was sending training videos to my colleagues every morning, and they could also choose what kind of exercises they wanted to do. The user choices were then stored in a database. Once again, that is just another example. As you can see, you can build very cool things with Line. And the best part is, you can get started for free, and the app itself is pretty developer friendly. But before I show you how you can get started today to build your own bot, let me briefly show you how it works. Now, there are two main concepts here that you need to understand. Webhooks and APIs. Let's start with APIs. Application Programming Interfaces. Think of an API like a menu in a diner. The menu provides a list of dishes you can order. When you specify which meal you want, the kitchen, so the system, prepares the dish and serves it. In the Line Messenger app, the API is the menu that lists all the various functions the app can perform. If you want to do something, like send a message or get user information, you could ask through the API, like ordering a dish, and Line, so the kitchen, responds by doing what you ask for. Webhooks, on the other hand, are slightly different. Imagine you're at home, and you want to be notified every time a letter arrives in your mailbox. You could, for example, go out and check your mailbox every minute. Or you could set up a bell that rings every time someone puts a letter in your mailbox. And a webhook is like that bell. And in Line, a webhook notifies your application, so your Python script, whenever something happens in your chat. So, for example, when someone sends a message to your Linebot, the webhook is a bell that tells your application, hey, there's a new message. So, in summary, an API is like a menu. You can ask Line to do specific tasks. And a webhook is like a bell that tells you when something happens in your chat application. So, for my Smart Sven Morning Bot, I use the API to send messages every morning. However, to respond to messages or when the user used the custom menu, a webhook was triggered. Now, all you really need to get started is a free Line account and a place to host your Python web application. The hardest part for me back then was actually figuring out how to get started and how to set things up. Depending on your interest, we could also build a sample project together, where I go through each step in all the details. If that's something you would like to see, let me know your idea of such a bot in the comments. However, for those who are really eager to get started, let me give you a quick version of it. First, download the app from the Google Play Store or Apple App Store and create an account. Then head over to the Line's developer website. I will also insert the link in the description. Here you want to log in with your Line account. Once logged in, create a new provider. For the provider, click on Create a Messaging API Channel. On the next page, fill out all the details and then click on Create. Once created, you will want to write down your channel secret, which you can find under your basic settings. Next, under Messaging API, you will want to create your channel access token and write it down somewhere. Once done, disable the auto reply messages and greeting messages, as we will use our own Python script to respond to messages. To do this, click on the edit button and then toggle off the greeting message and auto reply message, and instead turn on the webhooks. Now below the webhook option, click on messaging API settings. Okay, now the important step is setting up the webhook URL. Here you need to insert the web link to your Python script that handles the webhooks coming from Line. Meaning, when someone writes a message in your chat, Line will send a trigger to that URL. Fortunately, Line provides a starter template. Just search for Line Messaging API SDK for Python, and you will find the following GitHub page. But of course, I will also put the link in the description. Once you're here on GitHub, you will want to install the SDK, and below you can also find the starter template for a Flask app. However, I actually prefer the simplicity of Fast API. So, if you navigate to the example folder, you will also find the same example in Fast API. All I did was copy and paste this code into VS Code. Make sure you have stored your Line Channel Secret and Line Channel Access Token in your environment variables. Okay, and here's where the magic happens. When someone sends a Line message, the callback route will be triggered. After some error handling, you will find down below here what the app should do with that message. In my case, I will just respond with a text message saying "you just typed" and then reply with the same message. The only thing you now need to do is to deploy this fast API application somewhere. In my case, I have deployed it to DataSpace. And with that in place, all you need to do is to paste your webhook URL in here and save it. To demonstrate this, this is now my app, and when I type something, I will get the response. And here is also where the real magic happens. Let's say if I type the keyword fact, I want to get back a useless fact. So I can do that here in my script and check for the message text. In case of fact, I will call this API and return the response to the user. Let me quickly deploy this update to data. Once done, if I now type fact, I get back a random fact. Okay guys, and this was just a super quick demonstration on how to get started. As I mentioned already, I truly think that this is one of the best Python projects you can start. Not only it is super fun to create your own bot, but it could also easily impress potential employers in a job interview. And again, if you want me to build a full-blown line bot with a custom menu, let me know in the comments. As always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.